up, line up the flex. You still in lines up at flex. I kill you, your ghostwriter is next. Y'all gon' die a duet, quiet on set, acting like you sick. This ain't about who rich or who had a lot of hits. Ain't no backing out of this, backtracking out of this. Little fake Eminem, fast rapping out of this. No, hit us with your best impression of Drizzy. You ain't even the best in your city. Let me guess, it's the Henny.
DJ Bandana.
What's good, Bandana fam? It's DJ Bandana Black, Mr. Well Connected, even more respected. And yes, I am back. Had a wonderful birthday weekend. If you want to check out that video, you just got to go to the Bandana Family channel. You can check out everything I did for my birthday. But besides that, this video right here is kind of bad. Like, it kind of hurts because I jai rock with Tory Lanez. Like, Tory Lanez is jai a good dude. He did a couple little custom songs for me and all that, too. But I'm the number one Dipset fan, too. And I just want to say this starting off the video. With Tory Lanez, I like the confidence. I like, you know what I'm saying, just feeling like you better than everybody and all that. And you sending just general shots into the hip-hop community. I like that. I'm all for that. But when you do that, and you kind of can't pick and choose who you respond back to. And I say that to say this. J.R. Ryder and J. Hood both sent responses back to Tory Lanez. I can understand him right now probably not responding back to J. Hood. Shout out to J. Hood, too. But J.R. Ryder, like, he jai went in on the joint and got at Tory Lanez, and he didn't say anything back, but he wanted to respond back to Don Q. And Don Q seems like he's pretty much taking it a little bit past rap, a little bit past hip-hop. So I don't know. I need y'all to hop in the comments. I'm going to play a couple clips. I need y'all to hop in the comments. Let me know how y'all feel. Is Tory Lanez kind of picking and choosing his battles? I know a lot of you, it's always somebody who just going to disagree for no reason. So you're going to say, well, Don Q is relevant. J.R. Ryder is not relevant. No. If you actually look at, like, compare them to on any stats as far as music, sales, popularity, any of that. Now, Don Q is a little bit newer of an artist, but J.R. Ryder is still young, still buzzing in his industry. So, I don't know. I think he should have, if I was him, I would have responded back to J.R. Ryder before I responded back to Don Q, just for the simple fact of, we know J.R. Ryder is about that back and forth in battle life, whatever like that. But anyways, I'm gonna share y'all these two clips. The first clip is gonna be of Don Q sounding like he's pretty much getting serious with Tory Lanez. And then the second one is from a live clip that, Tory Lanez and DJ Academics was on live a few minutes ago. You see, I get the exclusive. Like, they probably still on live right now and I already got the joint. But anyways, I'm gonna share that with y'all. Make sure y'all like the video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Make sure you share this video. Here are the clips and then we're gonna talk a little bit more.
48 hours is up. Niggas is scared. Niggas is soft. Niggas don't wanna do nothing. Niggas don't wanna do nothing. Your 48 hours is up. You's a bitch. You don't wanna do nothing. You ain't got nothing to say. You riding around with New York niggas trying to get help. You trying to find out niggas' baby mom's name. You's a bitch, nigga. Come outside, nigga. You got nothing to say because you can't rap. You can't rap. All them niggas, what you tell them niggas, suck my dick. You from New York. You riding with that nigga, suck my dick. And we coming outside. Y'all know what's gonna happen when we come outside. You is not coming outside. Niggas had so much to say when the other nigga was on your ass. Now you quiet. You quiet now when a nigga barking on your ass, right? You a nigga barking on your ass, you quiet now, right? You talking all that shit, I done barked your ass up, you don't wanna do nothing, nigga. You got niggas in the studio giving you lines and shit. This nigga's garbage, get this nigga the fuck out of here talking about he the best rapper. This nigga's trash. You done had 3 days to say something, you got off the plane yesterday. If that was me, I'd have had my shit ready last night, I'd have dropped on you, nigga. Well, 48 hours is up.
Remember, I ain't say nothing, all I said was this. I said, I'm the best rapper alive. Give a fuck how anybody feel about it. Which I don't give a fuck about. I always stay true to that. I don't care what nobody think about that. This is a nigga I see in the studio all the time, my nigga. It all get different times of the day. You know, at all. I see this nigga a whole time.
Did you apologize for taking his, like, his
First of all, this whole apology, we met each other backstage, and I never said
Okay,
like
so you've seen both of the clips. In my opinion, it looks like Don Q is willing to take this a little bit past hip-hop, but I mean, it is what it is. If you put yourself out there, you got to be prepared for everything that comes with it. My only thing is, if J.R. Ryder is, like, I mean, coming at you just directly like that, you at least got to say something back, Tory. I mean, the fans want to hear that. But anyways, make sure y'all hop in the comments. Make sure you check out this right here. It's called Watch by Pretty Boy Peasy. This is off that No Favors mixtape on SoundCloud. Links will be in the description. This is just a clip of it. For the full song, you can click the link in the description. Check out the full mixtape and all that. You got some hot joints on there. DJ Bandana Black is the well connected, even more respected. I'm out.
Watch how I was making them mad. Watch how I was making them mad. Watch how I get to the money.